Welcome to this edition of ISTV English News. This is Kate Murray for the headlines. Rashtriya Krishi Vikas kicks off in Manipur. And Chief Minister inspects construction of Paraman Kaithal Market for the second consecutive day. And now the news in detail. Agriculture Minister N. Lokhel announced the Rashtriya Vikas Yojana kicks off in the state. He made a statement in connection with the inaugural function of 2 days Rabi campaign for 2010-2011 and integrated crop management orientation program. The orientation program was held in the Agriculture Department at Panchayat Bhavan, Porompat. MLA Dr. N.G. Bijoy, Chairman Manitko, MLA Mangi, Commissioner Agriculture Letkugin Hauki and Director Agriculture Palendro were also present in the inaugural function. Deputy Director of Agriculture Soil Chemist P.H. Rajendra expressed optimism that despite the late arrival of Rashtriya Vikas Yojana in the state, it will definitely help a lot in the agriculture sector. He also said that the department is ready to provide maize, pulses and mustard seeds for Rabi season. Commissioner Letkugin maintained that large-scale production of food crops is possible only when farmers of the state take keen interest and enthusiasm. He also stressed farmers need to consult with the officials of the department for better productivity. MLA Bijoy observed that the concept of farmers club should reach to the farmers and appeal the department to avail and extend all possible help to the poor farmers. Equipment should be made available to the farmers at subsidized rate. Minister Lokhel in his address maintained that our fields should be kept green always to bring about significant changes in the cultural sector. He asserted that Rashtriya Vikas Yojana is launched in the state. He further added that the Yojana will bring about a revolution in agriculture. The scheme, apart from benefiting agriculture, would also immensely boost in the veterinary, horticulture, sericulture and fishery. He also sought all possible cooperation and support from farmers in the successful implementation. Once again, Chief Minister O.E. Bobby inspected the ongoing construction of Khwairamand Ima Kaithal and Tribal Market at Lambulan today. Opposition leader Radha Binod Koizam, MLA Nandakumar, Minister D.D. Thaisi, MLA Mangi were also accompanied in the inspection. Speaking to the reporters after inspecting the pace of progress of the construction work, the Chief Minister said due to the slow pace of work, the market sheds will not be able to complete within this month, but within November. Though the government said the target to complete within this month, rains played the spoiled sport and could not make much progress, he added. Week-long national integration camp organized by Nehru Yuva Kendra Thaubal, which began from 26th of last month at Women Income Generation Center Thaubal Wang Matawa, has concluded today. A closing function held on the occasion was attended by MLA K. Mekachandra, commandant of the 15th Assam Rifles Sanjoy Ghosh, secretary of the Women Income Generation Center Indira Oinam, general director of Nehru Yuva Kendra Sangathan Imphal Zone J. Riva, and district youth coordinator Y. Lakshman as dignitaries on the dais. Participants in the camp from various states performed their cultural dance and music. Toppers in the essay competition, quiz and cultural program were awarded with certificates and mementos. Speaking on the occasion, a camper from Arunachal Pradesh expressed his satisfaction of visiting Manipur. He said that even though he was visiting state for the first time, he had to learn many things during the camp. MLA K. Megachandra, who graced the occasion as chief guest, said, organizing such a camp in the country inhabited by many communities will restore communal harmony in the society. Combined troop of Thaubal Police Commando and 12th Maratha Light Infantry apprehended one KCPMC cadre along with a loaded 9mm pistol from his residence at Awankuno village under Lamsang Police Station. According to a press statement of Thaubal District Police Additional SP, the cadre was arrested at around 3 a.m. today morning after the combined troop conducted search operation in the area. The arrested cadre has been identified as one Kumantem Shamu Singh, son of one Tombi Singh. He is about 45 years old. There was suspension of operations through the tripartite agreement involving the center, the state government and Cookie UG groups under two umbrella bodies, namely UPF and KNO, has been extended for a period of 1 year. Deposits of arms at the designated camps of the UG groups under UPF is to be reviewed. Extension of SUE period for 1 year with effect from August 22 last has been agreed during a joint meeting of representatives of Union Ministry of Home Affairs, State Government and leaders of UPF and KNO at New Delhi on September 29 last. The meeting had also laid down conditions for reviewing deposits of arms of the UG groups under UPF by the Joint Monitoring Group. Meanwhile, according to a reliable source, JRA, which is a group under UPF, has already deposited 44 weapons at its TECO designated camp. The government wants that at least 56 more weapons to be deposited. For construction of another designated camp of JRA, the government has directed identification of site within the current month so that the construction could be started and completed in time for inauguration in January next year. Imphal West District Police could nab a key cadre of proscribed outfit RPF PLA from a farm near Hangang Hill in Imphal East District. The arrest came through a well-orchestrated raid conducted under SDPO Imphal West, Madhunimai, in the adjoining area of Hangang Hill in the wee hours today.